Let's get one thing straight. I'm a small-time YouTuber. I made a YouTube channel a billion years ago, and then for a few years, I didn't post anything at all. But over the past few months, I just decided I'm gonna take YouTube seriously. And I tripled my subscribers. Yes, I tripled my subscribers. So today, I'm gonna share with you some of the tips and tricks that I've used over the past few months so that your channel can grow. My name is Patrick. I'm a husband, I'm a dad, and on top of being a worship pastor at a church in New York City, I also run my own tech company. And I make videos like this because I like to talk about gear and review gear and essentially just share my life with you. Let's get started. Okay, so here's my first piece of advice. Just give a s***. No, in all seriousness, you just need to start caring. And one of the ways you do that is by asking yourself two questions. Question number one, am I adding value? Like, is what you're uploading adding value to your life or even someone else's? And the second question I would ask myself is what you're uploading something you would watch? You see, you don't always have to enjoy the topic you're discussing in any particular video, but would you watch it? If you're sitting there editing your video that you've worked really hard on, and even during the editing process, you're getting fatigued and you want to click away, you might be in trouble. So beginning to care as if you are the viewer makes a huge difference. If you start to care about your channel, you're gonna see other people care about your channel and you will see growth. Okay, so the second thing is you have to set a goal. Do you want brand deals? Do you want a million subscribers? Any goal is actually okay, even if you're just trying to have fun. But at some point, you have to decide if you want YouTube to be a fun hobby or a platform that you are creating in with intentionality. Those things don't have to be mutually exclusive. For some people, working towards a goal like creating with intentionality is actually fun. I'm one of those people. But if you set goals with intentionality, you will see growth. I have several goals and I'm okay with these changing over time. I wanna create content that I'm proud of. I want to find a way to grow my channel in a way that makes YouTube's algorithm happy, but I want to enjoy it. Practically, I want to gain 1,000 subscribers and I'm actually well on my way. And long-term, I want YouTube to be another form of income for me and my family. So set goals, because if you plan to fail, you fail. I said it wrong. Set goals, because if you fail to plan, honestly, you plan to fail. So now that you've set some goals, it's time for you to actually get started. And sometimes people start their YouTube channel without setting a goal and then realize, I want to take this seriously. But once you get started, you have to realize something. Gear does not matter. If you're watching this video, chances are that you have a high definition camera in your pocket or somewhere near you right now. Most people start their YouTube channel and see significant growth while just using their phone. And that's okay. If you decide to make upgrades, let me give you a big tip. Start with audio first. You see, viewers will put up, they'll sit through a bad looking video, but sitting through a bad sounding video is no bueno. So if you are looking to make upgrades, start with audio. But don't forget, at first, gear just doesn't really matter. Okay, here's my next tip, and it's not a fun one. Be organized. So your gear is all set up, you're ready to record, be organized. There are ideas that shoot into my brain like lightning that I just film cold. Like I'll walk into my office and I'll be like, I need to shoot a video about this new product that just came out or this announcement that's currently happening right now from Apple. And often those videos work out. I just sit down, I shoot the video and it's great with some editing.
Enhance.
However, most of my videos are given tons of care and attention before I even push record. So hear me say this, you can have all the best gear in the world, but you're the only one who can truly organize your final product and your footage. So having a clear system for the ideas, the footage, the notes, the current projects, the completed projects, and more will save you tons of headaches. Trust me. You know, sometimes on my way to work, I'll get a text from my boss that says, I have to cancel our meetings for the rest of the day. I've got to be out of the office. Or I'm on my way home and I open my apartment door and it's completely empty. And when this happens, I'll work through lunch shooting video because I've taken the time to write out scripts and ideas in my notes app. And I'm ready to shoot whenever time permits. Your videos will get better if you give time to scripts, location, partnerships, and the video arc you're trying to create before you press record. Yes, sometimes lightning strikes, you get a video idea in your head, you shoot it and it works out perfectly. But you will see benefits of being organized ahead of time in your videos, and so will the people watching your videos. That's why I'm creating a video about how I do this that will be released in the near future. Be organized. You should also schedule your shoot days. Again, lightning can strike, you press record, you have a great idea for a video, and it all just flows out really naturally and looks and sounds amazing. But scheduling your shoot days is going to keep you sane in the long term. I also schedule time just to write. I take time to write out scripts and ideas for videos I want to shoot, and it helps me get all my ideas out so that I feel prepared on the days I want to shoot. Additionally, I record multiple videos in one day if I can. I actually keep a couple of extra shirts in my office in case I need to change up a look between shooting two or three different videos. You see, it takes about 15, 20 minutes to set up a mobile shooting rig, and you're thinking to yourself, that's not a really long time, but when you do that over and over and over again, it can get a little bit, you know, taxing. So sitting down and recording three videos right in a row that you can then take your time to edit and release every week or so is really going to help you stay in the YouTube game for the long haul. See, I've been shocked at times at how well a video came out that I was just inspired to do in the moment. No script writing, no planned scenes or narrative, just me and a camera and something I'm passionate about. Now, I'm not saying you have to do that. I'm just saying don't be afraid to do that. A lot of you, you thrive in an organized environment and you have a table of everything you want to talk about and a script and a teleprompter. But if you have a great idea, if you're sitting there and the lighting is just right, don't be afraid to just wing it. Don't be afraid just to press record and see what comes out. You might surprise yourself. This isn't a fun one, but yes, you should take time to make those final edits. Edit fatigue is real. Don't be afraid to walk away and finish your edit later, but finish your edit. Those extra few minutes are going to get you from this video's fine, it's passable, to this video is great. But editing is hard. So I have a crazy tip after we hear from our sponsor.
And now here's a word from our sponsor.
Today this video is sponsored by me. That's right, today's video is brought to you by our sponsor, me. We are thrilled to welcome me. Listen, visit iampatrickmurphy.com/learn. I think that all of these tips and best practices are helpful, but I don't ever want to give you the impression that they are easy. Maybe hearing everything that I have learned as a growing YouTuber is giving you all the motivation and inspiration you need. Maybe you kind of need an extra push, or maybe you still need a bit more help. That's okay. I would love to help you in any way that I can. So please take a moment. If you need a little bit of extra care, if you need some coaching, if you need some training, visit iampatrickmurphy.com/learn. Schedule a coaching session where we can learn how to grow your YouTube channel together. Thanks, sponsor. Just a second ago, we talked about edit fatigue. It's real. You have the ideas, you've recorded all of your footage, but editing just drains you. Now, for some of you, you love editing. You love finding your voice in the editing process. But others, you have all these creative ideas. The editing aspect of being a YouTuber just does not bring you joy at all. Hire an editor. Yeah, hire an editor. I know it sounds crazy, but it's not as expensive as you think. You see, I love to be creative and I actually like editing my videos to look exactly how I want, but I know that editing my videos is what takes the longest. Cutting that time out of my schedule would free me up for more. So one of the places I've found a lot of help is Fiverr. You can go right to fiverr.com, search for a YouTube editor that's actually going to make your vlogs come together, where you don't have to do any editing. You can just do all the creativity and shooting and let someone else help you find your voice in the editing process. I know it sounds crazy, but beginning to hire help as soon as possible will help you just relax your shoulders a bit as a YouTuber and just have fun in the process. Some of these editors, they start their packages at like 10 bucks for a 10-minute video. That's awesome, right? Yeah, it's easier than you think. So once your video is done, you have to get people to click on your video to actually watch it. So there's one chance you have to make a first impression, and thumbnails or graphics are that first impression, and they are way important. So there's plenty of YouTube tutorials out there that show you how to use free services to create thumbnails and different ideas of how to make them pop and what people are looking for on YouTube, but I just want to plug Canva, canva.com. That's the service I use because it's absolutely free to go and create graphics and thumbnails and presentations and animations for your video. If you haven't created a Canva account to make thumbnails and animations and things like that for your video, you should start doing that today. One thing I would add in here, after we've talked about getting organized and we've talked about creating a schedule and how to get your video out there, is just your own personal health. Go on YouTube right now and search through your favorite YouTubers' videos. You're probably gonna find some video where they say, I need a break, I'm burned out. Or you're gonna find a significant gap in their upload times. That's because if you go on any creative platform, at some point you're just gonna go, I need some me time. So instead of having this crash and burn moment, just as you're uploading, as you're creating, take some time to ask yourself, am I healthy? And I really, really mean this. If you are in a place where you're struggling, reach out to me. Send me some sort of an email, patrick@iampatrickmurphy.com, or leave a comment on this video and just say, hey man, I need some encouragement. I'll be your guy. Your health is more important than your content. That was a lot, and I know that there's lessons that I still need to learn. There's things that I did not mention in this video that I should have, but the best advice anybody can ever give you is you've got to start. Maybe you're the person that's been watching the YouTube tutorials for the longest time about how to start a channel in 2021. You just have to start, because what you have to share with the world is something that the world needs and wants to see. So I hope this video was helpful. If there's anything I did miss, let me know in the comments. Do all of the YouTube things, like this video, subscribe to my channel. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Also, don't forget to sign up for one of those coaching sessions at iampatrickmurphy.com/learn. Come on.